You know, one thing I noticed, white women really haven't been disrespecting Kevin Samuels. You hear me? Majority of the people disrespecting Kevin Samuels has been the black women. I don't see white women groups having a foundation to go against this man, saying a lot against him. And he didn't make his specific attributes and disses aimed towards a specific general group of women, meaning that a black woman. He said women in general. He has plenty of receipts of him going in regardless of the race and nationality of that woman. So I'm only bringing that up to say that tells you a whole lot about us, bro. It's only majority of our women out here doing a disdain thing. These are women, bro. I want a lot of you men to see when you men are killing each other for these women. I want you to know how heartless majority of our women can be. I'm talking about RBLACK women. I don't know why we can't say it like that, but the algorithm of the internet don't like that word, so we said that like that. Now, it's like we're predestined for it, but these women don't care when you die. Pookie and Ray Ray fighting for Shaquisha, and Shaquisha's with Jamal down the street. After both, one nigga dead, one nigga got 30 years to life football numbers. Keisha down the street with Jamal, bruh. And after she with Jamal, she might be with me, bro. Facts. Mines, if she's out there like that, might not cry for me and be with you. I'm just telling you what it is, bruh. I do not see white women doing this. I'm not trying to say they better. I'm not one of these dudes who do all that extra. I'm just telling you what I see. I don't see them being the ones out there saying the most and doing the most. Now, some of y'all done said some foul things, but I've seen some stupid ones, too. I've seen people who took the initiative to say, Kevin Samuels, you feel me? He ain't living that life. They found him dead in an apartment, not a mansion, not a condo. He was lying about what he... I was like, at a time hearing about a man dead, that's what you was paying attention to? Whether he was dead in a condo or a mansion, it mattered about an apartment, made him look bad. Like, this was too crazy. It's too crazy. You don't know if that was his house or not, or a friend's house. And even if it was his, that was more important than the news of him dying. Because when you're celebrating, nothing makes sense anymore. Where is the safe haven, bruh? The safe haven in your own heart to keep you away from the F-ish, bro. Y'all doing a lot. I hear my kids making noise upstairs, but I ain't mad at them, man. I'm in the garage feeling good to be alive right now. Let me knock on wood for my graces. I ain't religious, but I'm a strong faith man. And I just feel like Kevin Samuels, everything happened for a reason, but that reason wasn't yours. You didn't have this power to kill this man. First of all, passive aggressive people can't get anything out the way. I feel like this thing of ours is showing us who we really are, man. To say that about one Kevin Samuels and throw everything out the loop in a way like that is telling me that Kevin Samuels touched a nerve on you. He bothered you so much that even with this man not being dead for 20-some hours, you're concerned with him. You know what I mean? And like I said, man, I'm shocked. I'm looking around. Where are all these white women who don't like black people? I'm keep hearing they use black men just for the kids, educational purpose, all that. Because I don't see, and I'm pretty sure there's some, but where is the majority of them, the big publications? Where is all of them making videos saying celebration? You see it from one group of people. One group of people. You can't dispute that. You see that for only one group of people for selfish reasons other than themselves. You hear what I'm telling you? Listen to me, kings and queens. This ain't life, man. The way they did that brother as far as name after death is almost like this man has destroyed nations. It's crazy. And Kevin Samuels would have never been big as he is if what he's saying wasn't true or if it didn't hit a nerve. So all you people with your fake outrage towards Kevin Samuels, you helped that brother get big. You hear me? You made him get bigger with your fake outrage. Your fake outrage let other bigger publications say, who is this man? Why does he got everybody riled up and they got it? Bingo. It was the man with the plan. Kevin Gates, nah. Little Boosie, nah. The Hood Hero is a man who doesn't even seem street at all. He's Kevin Samuels. I don't follow him. I don't really support the brother, but I know he's Kevin Samuels. I don't care about the celebrity and all that. He's Kevin Samuels. He's a human being. He's being ridiculed through the streets right now. And you had one person who went on Clubhouse and he just asked me, He's like, he really didn't know who Kevin Samuels is. Shout out to the UK. Maybe he's lying. I don't know, but it sounds very truthful. He said, who is Kevin Samuels? What did he do? It seems like he deserved his death. And I was like, why? He was like, man, the things I've heard about Kevin Samuels is based on what these females said about it. And I was just thinking, what? But then I'm like, if I didn't know who Kevin Samuels was either, and I just see the hate he's getting, you would think he killed people and their families and everything. But then when you find out the reason of these people's visceral and anger, and it's like, wait a minute, because he said what your weight was is not healthy, or he gave his opinion on how, if he think you're very pretty or extra pretty or moderately pretty, and that turned you out into this monster to attack dead people, bro. This is crazy, man. I don't know what to say more than crazy, man. We need to certify ourselves as dominant men and women once again, man. Because this behavior and feeling that's being exuded out of a lot of y'all is strange. It's very strange, and it's unbecoming of any person who deems themselves as a melanated man and woman, righteously so. You ain't righteous, man. You fakely so. You are here. So you got the most to say about white women. These white women showing out today and showing that at times they can display better measurables than you guys. Not that I agree with it or not, but it's being displayed right now. So what do I say? What do you say then? It's majority of us. Y'all know it. That's why I don't have to show you no receipts of what our women are saying about Kevin Samuels right now, because you all see it. It's one of them things where I didn't need no receipt. We pretty much know when certain black men die what black women are going to say. It's almost without a doubt. And I'm probably going to get it being said by me, by a couple of these black women, even though I don't subscribe to what Kevin Samuels pushing out there. But I do respect my brother. He ain't never said nothing ill of me. I just disagreed with him when he was on the come up in the Madmosphere years ago. Shout out to him. I don't know. I just use him as motivations. I don't listen to him, but watching his platform, seeing it grow the way it grow, it gave me hopes of mine, which I finally got a YouTube award, all that. Didn't even know it was reachable. And I'm not saying he did it, but when you see certain people establish themselves, you know you could do it too, because you here too. You just as talented. So I don't have time to hate on people. What they could do, why I can't do it? Why be jealous of somebody? If you really want to do what that person is doing, go out and seek it and do it yourself. But if you copying that person just to copy them, you have envious venom in you. And you just did it because of some evil reason that existed in you. White women are showing out and showing they got it. They know how, and they didn't like what Kevin Samuels had to say, but you don't see them joining a Power Ranger group of task force of the Justice League who hates Kevin Samuels, and now let's be against him. It's strange. And a lot of y'all alphabet communities, with all due respect to y'all, I don't know what terminology to call y'all, so I'm trying to be respectful. It's just being honest. We live in a world where saying something accidental because you don't know what to say could get you in trouble, get your business shut down, get you canceled. So it's dangerous in how you use certain words. So I will say it like this. That particular community who wants everybody to bow down before them and respect everything they say, even if that thing is not for certain people, people shouldn't have to be forced into it, but you're telling people X, Y, and Z. It's amazing to see that same community wishing for the death of Kevin Samuel and receiving it and celebrating it. That's wild, man. I don't know what else to say more than the hypocrisy of democracy. Everybody cries for democracy, but there lies the only the hypocrisy. Like that, you can't have democracy and part of that, but I guess you can intertwine them according to these people. But it is what it is, man. Look, rest in peace. I'm not going to call him the Godfather. Again, I didn't follow or subscribe to Kevin Samuels, but I will say rest in peace to that man. You feel me? To his family, I hope y'all have some sort of relationship where it could be a rest in peace. Look, man, stay blessed. Love your family, love your kids, and definitely, definitely stay blessed, man.